So I'd like to do a couple simple drug calculations with you to get you started in this chapter. We're going to use the formula method desired over half times quantity. In your workman text, it doesn't show quantity for pills because our quantity is usually just one tablet. But I like to always plug that in just to kind of keep me on track of what kind of unit I'm working with. So here we go. Let's just plug some numbers in. Don't make these hard. They're not hard. So a patient is ordered 500 milligrams of metformin. Metformin is available in 250 milligram tablets. How many tablets do you give? So let's plug our numbers in. Our desired is the doctor has ordered 500 milligrams. So our desired is 500 milligrams. Metformin is available 250 milligram tablets. So we have 250 milligram per one tablet. So let's just do the math. Let's cancel out milligrams. So 500 divided by 250 is 2 times one tab equals 2 tablets. That's what we're gonna give, okay? Desired over half times quantity. Let's try a couple more. So the doctor has ordered 50 milligrams of Dilantin. The drug is available 125 milligrams per 5 ml. How many ml will you give? So plug our numbers in. The doctor has ordered 50 milligrams of Dilantin, so our desired dose is 50 milligrams. The drug is available, this is what we have, 125 milligrams per 5 ml. So we have 125 milligrams per 5 ml. So let's just do our math. Let's cancel out milligrams. So 50 divided by 125 is 0.4 times 5 ml. And that gives us 2 ml. So we're going to be giving this patient 2 ml of Dilantin, or generic name would be phenytoin. Okay? Let's do one more. So the physician has ordered Zofran, or ondansetron, 10 milligrams. And let's get some blank paper here. It comes from the pharmacy. The label says ondansetron, 40 milligrams per 20 ml. So here we go, desired over half times quantity. The doctor has ordered Zofran, 10 milligrams. So our desired dose is 10 milligrams. The label says, what do we have? It says that we have 40 milligrams per 20 ml. Okay, so let's just do the math. Let's cancel out milligrams. So 10 divided by 40 is 0.25 times 20 ml. And that gives us 5 ml when we do the math. So we're going to give that patient 5 ml of medication. Well, I hope that helps. That'll get you started.